Yes guys, karibuni to a part 2 of my painful scar. Hapa tunaendelea tukisikiza story ya Mr. William. Tumeendelea tukiona venye the mom passed away, alafu the dad pia, challenges zenye wamekuwa nazo kwa familia, and now he is in the hospital pale Loitoktok, a couple of hours away from Taita, their home. Na hapa hivi anaendelea kuonwa ama kutikiwa care na brother yake. Tunataka tuendelee kusikiza his story, but before we get there guys, this show is proudly sponsored by DreamWorks Investment Limited. They are an architectural company. Wanafanya all your design, unataka za nyumba, crafting, anything you do. Unataka kufanya flat zako, unataka kujenga flat zako, kujengia mzazi, any spaces that you have, unataka zikuwa refurbished. These are the guys to look for. We have their contacts here on the screen. Make sure you check them out na utakuwa sorted vizuri sana. And so yes, William.
Yes.
Bado tunaendelea na story. Hapa tulikuwa tumefika, you're in hospital now.
Yeah.
Kuna vile unaona it's a tough situation. Lazima wakutoe maji yenye iko kwa kichwa because of meningitis. Mm. So they have to put you in a situation and put into so much pain. So unaweza endelea maybe kutuelezea about the story.
So before I continue, I can say people a family.
Mm-hmm.
Family are not those people you are born with. That one I can attest to you. Family is those people who have taken care of you and everything. Because the family of my dad, when they knew I was passing through that, the only statement they said it was, nitolewe Taveta, nipelekwe huko, so that wapunguze cost ya kusafirisha jeneza.
What? So walikuwa naona like utakufa, ama walikuwa naona like you cannot make it.
Yeah. What? They called my aunt akamwambia, ndo wasipate shida ya kunisafirisha nikuwa nimekufa, niende nikufie huko, ndo ikuwe cut the cost ya kubeba the body from Taveta to that place. That's why I don't like associating with them at all.
And this time when mtoto bado.
Yeah. That time I was, when my aunt was telling me that, I was, okay. And that is how ties me nilisema, just because even now many think I died or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
Many things that way. But I'm here, God had any help. I'm here.
Yeah.
So I was in the hospital and hiyo nikafanikiwa vizuri, nikatolewa, the maji ikaisha, and sasa hiyo paralysis ndo ilikuwa iko sasa, left side haifanyi, is not functioning.
Mm-hmm.
So ikakuwa na issues tu, yani walking was an issue.
Mm-hmm.
Kanapelekwa physiotherapy, kufanyiwa massage, nini hizo zote. And my aunt, what really helped me was God.
Mm-hmm.
My aunt was very prayerful. I remember there was a time I think I died because ushayamuka kwa bed unapata familia yako imezingira the bed. It was the worst kind.
So like wanadhani they are crying ama wanadhani ni kama umekufa.
Because when you see my sister ametoka kwa umbali, because it was like an 8-hour journey amekuja. You know how things would go meenda. So I woke up from bed, nilizimia. I was actually, I'm a fan of animation and cartoon. I was watching at home, hapo kwa auntie.
Mm-hmm.
And I said, I'm feeling kichwa inaniuma, nikasema, let me go and sleep kidogo.
Mm-hmm.
When I went to sleep, kesi niliamkia wapi? Niliamkia tena kwa bed ya osi.
What?
I convulse. And it was tu imebaki kidogo karibu nitayarishwe niende mochari. It was that serious. And that is why my sisters were there. Everybody ilikuwa hapo naamka. Kumbe mtu akikufa ajuake.
So ulikuwa umeenda like umeenda kulala tu kawaida
yeah,
yako.
Yeah.
Ni usiku unataka kulala, but then yeah, you wake up, there's so much, unafikia ni kama unaona ni kama there's so much that happened within that time.
Yeah, there is, I think nilienda tu, and then our house manager who was taking care of me,
mm-hmm,
anaitwa Lydia, and she's now that girl, sijui ninaweza mshukuru na nini.
Mm-hmm.
She really made me, yeye ndo aliniokoa hiyo time.
Mm-hmm.
Kanipeleka usiku. aliniambia I was filled with inaitwa mapofu. Mapofu it is form. Ile yenye ukikufu na hizo.
Yeah.
So yenda aliniokoa and we went to Nindo nikajipata usi. I was not, aliniambia I was not moving, I was just there. Evil dead dead. Dead dead.
You were like dead.
I was just evil. And my aunt every time alikuwa ananipitisha through prayers every day. Every day William omba hivi and that really helped me because God ndo alifanya until I became nikakuwa well. Even when people wrote walini write off like I cannot make it ama something, she was there for me. Actually ile siku aliambiwa atume ndo apunguze safari ya maiti, aliwakemea and akasema William will be well, will be well in the name of Jesus. And from Danny, that's why I say my life is just God. God tundo amekuwa na mimi because hakuna binadamu angekuwa na mimi like how God amekuwa na mimi. And mambo yaliendelea vizuri tu, tuliendelea nikapita hizo mambo ya ku my side left ikarudi, lakini sasa nilikuwa na chachemea. Kuchachemea ni kutembea ukilimba. So nikabaki na hiyo, that is the after effect of the paralysis of one side.
Na hapa kwa hizi times ulikuwa kwa hospitali, was it a 1 week ama just a few days?
I wish it was 1 week. Nilikuwa na kaa napata 3 months uko. Sometimes I was just giving up. Kuna time I was just crying, I gave up. Nikasema me, I'm not doing this. I even told my aunt, you're using a lot of money to take me to hospitals and I'm not getting even better. I was telling even my late brother, just let me nikufe and at least you'll not have what is it called, the expenses hospitali kila time. Because ushaifika place unauma paka unajiona you are nuisance, umaanza kukua tuwe ni mtu tu wa kufanya things zikuwe, yani unapeana tu expenses they were not expected.
Unaulikuona kama ni mzigo,
umekuwa ni mzigo. Niliona kama mimi ni mzigo to my aunt because pesa alitumia on my side and knowing she's just my aunt. Yani God to him place because it was not even she was alikuwa kwa kazi poa lakini just sacrificing your do yote for me to be okay, kunipeleka kwa different, even going to, I think I went to a private hospital in a place, it was very expensive. Akanipaka, imagine tulijaribu paka miti shamba.
To see if you can do something.
We went even to our, not mganga, herbalist, our natengeneza dawa za miti shamba. Just to see if I'll be okay.
She tried literally everything.
Everything, yani anything a mom can do to her son. Alinifanyia everything. Nikarudi shule, I was not that good. Even this English which nachocha hapa saizi. I learned it, I think, while I was in class, I think 7 or when. Because hizo effect zote zilinirudisha nyuma and I became not that okay with my speech, with anything. I was not even this confident. Because anytime you go to school, people are laughing at you. Wewe ni weak. Sometimes I even sikuwa nacheza. And then I was very heavy. Nilikuwa mnene sana. So before nikuwa msika, I was very mnene. So sometimes we hata mwenye the self-esteem inashuka. And you feel like, sasa utafanya nini because vitu zimekuramba. Yani even my education, I was not concentrating at all. Kichwa nayo, ilikuwa bado tu inakimbizana ikiuma. So I started being on medication from an early age of jua hizo medications za kichwa or hizo. So also my memory ikaenda.
Ilipotea
yote. My memory ikakuwa na issue ya I can keep things but not that for long. But say at least I've tried and they are never keep. So I was not this okay. So and then after hizo vitu zote God akani tukaenda vizuri with my aunt, tuka tukatokataveta. Mm-hmm. And then akakuwa transferred to Embu. She was working for a corporation ya government.
Mm-hmm.
Where they deal with plants. She was an inspectorate hapo. Mm-hmm. So tukakuja into Embu, akakuwa transferred huko kukuwa mkubwa wa the region. Mm-hmm. Embu. So tulipokuja Embu I think in 2010, I went nikakuja shule inaitwa Modern Green. Mm-hmm. Academy, which is just here in Embu County.
Mm-hmm.
I started, now I continued from class 7 to 8. Nikapita vizuri, but since with my health was not okay, singeenda boarding.
Mm-hmm.
So I went to a secondary school, a day school.
Mm-hmm.
Which is iko inaitwa Itabwa, sahi inaitwa St. John Paul the Second High School, which is the best name for it. So for me even to be this courageous, I was not this. I was sikuwa mtu muongea, sikuwa naongea sana.
Mm-hmm.
But when I went to Modern Green, at least class 8, I started growing my speech,
mm-hmm.
my English, my public speaking, nikajaribu from hapo.
Mm-hmm.
And then when I went to secondary school, hapo sasa ndo visanga zingine zikaingia, self-esteem. And this one inashikaga kila msee mwenye ako akiingia form 1.
Mm-hmm.
My skin tone was my letdown all through.
Mm-hmm.
I was never comfortable with my skin tone.
Mm-hmm.
When I went to high school, wase walikuwa wananiita tu Giza. Wananiita Nduma.
What?
Hata walimu walikuwa wananiita hivyo. So
even the teachers
walikuwa wananiambia nikianguka nasikia wewe Nduma something. It was the most heartbreaking. That was on form 1.
Mm-hmm.
Form 1, I had the lowest self-esteem ever. Can I ever have someone? Because nilikuwa naambiwa mimi sijui ni nini. Tutu mingi. So, back to the story, my brother, 2020, nikuwa bado high school. I think nikuwa nishatoka high school.
Mm-hmm.
So my brother also was also murdered. Was killed in very weird ways, which I cannot explain because it is more spiritual.
Oh, did you get to know maybe ni strangers?
No, it's the same people too. It is because of land. And I'm wondering, land, why should land make you kill your blood? For me, I was not touched because I just disowned that family.
Mm-hmm.
Not their own. And they know that. I cannot even be called by their name because I told them, even when I become successful, they should not come and say, oh, this is our son, not your son.
And this is the family and you walikuambia you will not amount to anything.
They chased us out. It was the same people. And then when you become successful, they come there saying, they're your son. I said, no.
Mm-hmm.
That one should never happen. The way they mistreated my other sisters, I said, no. Mm-hmm. I cannot do that.
Mm-hmm.
God helped me. I had a family. God akanipea familia.
Mm-hmm.
Alinipea my aunt alipomaliza form 4. Unajua pia hata unaangaliaga your aunt amekuwa na wewe until form 4.
Mm-hmm.
So yeye akarudi Taveta to back to his businesses za Tanzania and whatever. Mimi nikabaki in Embu where I became my other home.
Mm-hmm.
Until now it is my home.
Yeah.
So in Embu also I got another family.
Wow.
Yani God alifanya vitu, I got a mom and a dad because I never had a... When you miss the love of your mom, ilianza kuniafe because God now sasa, my dad at least I had time with him, so I had at least the love of dad, but the mom sikuwa nayo.
Mm-hmm.
So when I came to Embu, God gave me a mom.
Mm-hmm.
And he became too close. So in Embu, God akanipea mathi.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, anaitwa Catherine Kiura.
Wow.
Yeah, and a dad called Paul Kiura, and I have other sibling called Ephraim.
Mm-hmm.
And Favor.
Mm-hmm.
So
this is the family you came to know here
In Embu, and they became family even kushinda the other people.
So God anaweza toa like these are the family akuweke like hata kama si biological like they love you like they are your son.
They love me like my own, like they have sacrificed also a lot for me.
Mm-hmm.
Yani every time kuna time wako ananilisha yani tu vitu more.
Mm-hmm.
And then now back to high school. Mm-hmm. where the self-esteem was not okay.
Mm-hmm.
Because of my skin tone.
Mm-hmm.
The nilikuwa na insultiwa sana because of this takala. Mm-hmm. Oh, wewe usijui nini nini. But when the confidence, I think it grew after third term when I was in Form 1.
Mm-hmm.
That is when I knew I am a leader. I can lead people.
Mm-hmm.
I was actually a rapper. Yeah.
You know, ilikuwa talent.
Yeah, I was talented. So mm-hmm. what grew my confidence was during the prize giving day of the school.
Mm-hmm.
We were doing some rehearsals. I was Form 1, I think that time I went sijui wale wanafanya presentation kwa za, or praise giving kwa the parents.
Mm-hmm.
So that time nilikuwa nimejifunza to rap kidogo.
Mm-hmm.
Kuna rap. I was mm-hmm. an artist that time. So nilikuwa najaribu rap kidogo.
Mm-hmm.
And nikajaribu kidogo, nikakosha mwalimu. Kukosha mwalimu ni nikamfanya akapenda. So nikamkosha mwalimu.
Mm-hmm.
Mwalimu akasema you'll be on the rap. The day nilirap hivi, every person celebrated me. That is wow. where the turning point started.
Mm-hmm.
I went and did that rap in front of the parents for the first time.
Mm-hmm.
The standing ovation.
Wow.
That is where the silliness of dark skin sijui nini iliisha.
Mm-hmm.
So when the other time when they came to, when the walimu wanakuja sijui kuniambia, oh, we ni giza nini, nakwambia yes, I'm very greasy, hata ukinimulika sionekani. So it became more of a joke.
Uh-huh. Will you accept, no, yeah, kusema, this is it, me.
Yeah, I accepted being
it's your own problem, is this me. Is me. Uh-huh.
So anytime before somebody comes and tells you you are ugly,
mm-hmm.
you just accept yourself and use that as your boosting power. Because anytime wenye walikuwa wanajaribu kuniambia oh, we ni mweusi, before hata msia anianzie we ni mweusi, because that is the only thing ako nayo, anaweza kugonga nayo.
Mm-hmm.
Before akugonge nayo, we tayari ushajisema mi tayari hata kinimulika sionekani. Yeye yeah. usha mgonga hivyo ya
mm-hmm.
asha what is it called?
Mm-hmm.
Hata tumia you to his tena. Advantage.
Kwa zaliko na thani, like, yon do ineza kugonga. But now this, IESI fanya anything.
That one builds you. And that one, from that time, I became the president of journalism club.
Mm-hmm.
From Form 2. I'm the only president who broke the record. Because journalism club was led by Form 4s.
Mm-hmm.
But I became the president since Form 2 until Form 4 when I left.
Wow.
And also became the leader of opposition. In the same school.
Mm-hmm.
I was leading people into opposing that government using the journalism club. I also, and then I, when it reached Form 4, I think the school saw I was becoming a big opposer. They brought me into the government as the prime minister. But still I was the head of the president of journalism. So I was still the
mm-hmm.
I was still the opposition in government.
That's my politics.
And God can show that is the way I should go. And I finished my Form 4 vizuri. Actually, my Form 4, I think my secondary school was the most.
Mm-hmm.
It was, that was where I awakened everything. Kila kitu iliamka from my side.
Mm-hmm.
So the other issues zilikuja after Form 4.
Mm-hmm.
But Form 4 is where it opened my eyes from high school. That is where it built my leadership skills and everything.
Mm-hmm.
Until now I'm a leader.
Wow.
Yes.
Wow. Hey. Yeah. Kidogo hapa tungeendelea tu kusikiza this story because it's so interesting na it's so inspirational. Yani kutoka pale ukiwa mdogo, growing up and all the challenges yenye umepitia. But look at you now. Hata wakisema story mingi mingi pale giza nini nini, you are good in your own skin.
Yeah, mimi ni giza.
Yeah, so ume accept na wewe uko sawa.
Giza totoro. Kwanza giza totoro.
That is amazing. So unajua tungeendelea na his story. Sijui ni kutafuta tena tusonge tena with the leadership na yeah. story after that, you know.
Yeah.
So yes, thank you sana Mr. William for coming to for our show.
Nashukuru sana.
Najua tumekuwa personally nimekuwa inspired sana by that touching story.
Yeah.
And I know kuna watu pia hapa watching us when you're making inspired in one way or another. And guys, this is where we come to an end of this show. Tunaweza mwita Mr. William tena endelee na story. But remember, this show is proudly sponsored by DreamWorks Investment Company. Inile, they deal with all your construction. Unataka project management. Unataka kujengewa nyumba yako vizuri uchorewe. The house that unataka, flats, spaces, yoyote yenye unataka refurbished. These are the guys to look out for. Make sure you reach them out through these numbers we have here on the screen. Na utakuwa sorted vizuri sana. So see you guys on our next episode. I have been your host, Reni Njoroge.